In a move expected since the end of 2016, Anthem Sports and Entertainment officially announced that they had entered into a definitive agreement to acquire a majority interest in TNA Impact Wrestling. The media company also owns the Fight Network, a big player in the combat sports in Canada and 30-plus countries, as well as TNA's exclusive broadcast partner in Canada. In a press release, Anthem announced that Executive VP Ed Nordholm would become president of Anthem Wrestling Exhibitions, LLC. As for Dixie Carter, the release said that she would step down as chairman of the board and join the advisory board for Fight Media Group. She will remain a minority equity stakeholder.
I don't think a down-home Southern white girl is a minority of anything.
Wow. Yeah, I don't think she stuck around very long,
I feel like she's gone right after this, but I don't know the history of that. I stopped watching it, so.
Well, I mean, I don't know for sure. Obviously, I have no inside knowledge on any of this stuff, but what I'm thinking is she probably came in and was like trying to, hey, why don't we do this, and how about this, whatever, and they're like, oh, you still work here?
I pretend.
Yeah, and she's like, what do you mean? I don't get a say anymore? And they're like, yeah, you own like 5% of this company, so just go home and collect a paycheck. In fact, if I was Anthem,
oh,
I'd
you're, be like, you're pretty liberal with that. Huh? Oh, go get a paycheck. From what? You don't have a paycheck. You need to be making something.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's like they were probably like, look, you're lucky that we let you stick around in any capacity, all right? We're still paying off your debts, lady. Get out of here.
I literally said, lady.
whatever. But well, when there was actually like a lot of talk when they took the company, they said, yeah, there's a huge amount of debt that they're taking on by buying out Impact that was run up by Dixie Carter.
Oh man, yeah.
I mean, if you listen,
everyone go straight to Hogan and Bischoff's contracts, because Bischoff had an aneurysm over that.
Yeah, right. Well, according to Bischoff and Pritchard both, they said at a certain point, the Carter parents, I can't remember, Janice and Bob Carter, I think, the parents of Dixie.
Janice for sure. That was a business weapon, yes.
Yeah, right. I think it was Bob Carter. They said they cut Dixie off, like, company-wise. They're like, yeah, we're not pumping any more money into that company. And Bischoff and Pritchard were like, we're just now starting to get going. And you're like, nope, it's either going to sink or swim on its own. It's like, do you realize how long it takes to turn a profit from one of these companies? Like, we're right on the cusp. And you're like, nope, figure it out. Whatever. I mean,
hope it's not a sign of things to come.
Yeah, right.